In 1859, Darwin speculated that bears evolved into whales. But does this story hold water? Secular scientists support Darwin's hunch with two main arguments. One, fossils, and two, useless features, also known as vestigial features. They claim that fossils show a clear evolutionary progression from land mammals to whales. But many of these fossils are incomplete. Take the famous fossil Pachycetus. Scientists first found an incomplete skull, and it didn't even have a body. Later, a more complete Pachycetus discovery revealed perfectly normal legs. Pachycetus lived on land. Or Rhodocetus. At first, with only one head, spine, and a few other bones, secular scientists imagine it had front flippers and a whale tail. But just like Pachycetus, later discoveries revealed that it was just a land-dwelling mammal. Sadly, some museum illustrations still show whale tails on Rhodocetus. Without Pachycetus or Rhodocetus, the main missing links vanish from whale evolution. So, we have whale kinds or land mammals, but nothing in between. Secular scientists often point to vestigial features as evidence for evolution. They assumed that certain whale hip bones were useless legs left over from land mammals evolving into whales. Come to find out, those bones play a pivotal role in helping whales reproduce. They aren't useless at all. The most complete scientific evidence refutes Darwin's hunch. Instead of transitional fossils and useless features, we find fully formed creatures according to their created kinds.